Wonderful moments to you all, and welcome to OVCHEM Consult Limited. Today we're going to be looking at residential safety tips. It's no news that we are in the second wave of the COVID-19 pandemic. Many of us have come back to working from home. Now that we are working from home, we must be very safety conscious so that we can prevent accidents. Before we look into the presentation today, I just want to let you know that safety is gainful. And if there is anything you must put into practice, that should be safety. Safety is gainful, accident is painful. Now we move into the presentation, which is residential safety tips. We're going to look at part one. After this, we're going to have another part, which is going to be the part two. So we look at residential safety tips, part one, a visual safety presentation of OVCHEM Consult Limited. We look at this presentation under the following thematic areas. We look at the meaning of residential safety, look at safety tips for kitchen, we look at safety tips for bathroom, and we look at safety tips for furniture. We'll go to the first thematic, which is meaning of residential safety. Residential safety is literally means freedom from residential accidents, or the state of being free from residential accidents. Examples of residential accidents are fire breaks, electric shock, burns, cuts, trips and falls, falling objects. Look at the next thematic, which is safety tips for kitchen. Because many of us are going to be working from home because of the second wave of the COVID-19 pandemic, and some of us are going to be spending some time in the kitchen getting food ready. We'll look at the safety tips we need for kitchen. Always dress for fire safety in the kitchen. Avoid loose clothing such as nightgowns or bathrobes. What this point is talking about is we shouldn't go into the kitchen with loose clothing. See the second point, which is regularly clean any grease built up from the cooker, oven, stove, and exhaust fan. Cooking grease and oil ignite easily, burn rapidly. Never leave your cooking unattended to. If you must leave the kitchen for some unavoidable reasons, lower the heat and take something with you as a reminder that you have something cooking. Keep off-flammable objects such as towels, hot holders, hand gloves, and paper bags away from cooker, oven, stove, etc. To prevent burns, use clean kitchen safety gloves when taking items in and out of the oven or when removing cooking from the stove. Never use gloves that have soaked up oil or water because it could lead, or they have the potential of catching fire and also transmitting heat. Avoid reaching over the stove for anything while cooking. Keep frequently needed items in other areas of the kitchen. In case of a stove top fire, cover the pot or pan with a lid or a bigger pan to deprive the fire of oxygen. What this point is talking about is you're cooking and there's a fire as a result of your cooking, perhaps on your pots. All you need to do is just to get something to cover the pot so that you can deprive that source of fire or that fire from oxygen. Move to the next thematic, which is safety tips for bathroom, which is very important. We're going to be taking our bath, so we need to be conscious of safety. The bathroom is ranked as the most likely area of a household where a person may fall because of its often cramped space and slippery surfaces. Therefore, never touch any electrical appliances when bathing. Floors should be properly dried or cleaned. Ensure that any medication, soaps, detergent, bathroom cleaning supplies, and other ample substances are carefully stored out of reach of children. Store bathroom appliances such as air dryer away from from water. Look at safety tips for furniture. Ensure choice of furniture items should exclude those with sharp edges and corners. This will reduce chances of injury. Shelves should be low enough to avoid using steps too. Furniture should be stable, not wobbly. All stairs, whether inside or outside the house, require stable handrails. Let me deliberate more on this. In some of the buildings, we have stairs, and sometimes the openings in between the handrails of the stairs are too big and too open. So in that situation, we'll advise that make sure that the openings are, you know, to an extent reduced, so that if you have kids, they do not push themselves or fit themselves through those openings, because this could lead to fatal accident. Dilapidated structures or furniture should be removed or repaired. Thank you for listening. If you have questions, after this slide, I'm going to be dropping our contacts. You could reach out with your questions to our contacts, as well as your comments. This presentation is coming to you courtesy OVCHEM Consult Limited. OVCHEM Consult Limited is an engineering, environmental services, safety, training, and a chemical company. Wherever you are listening to us. If you need to reach out to us via our mobile contact, they are all displayed on the screen. We have our email address there. You can, you know, like our page on Facebook and follow us as well at www.facebook.com/OVCHEM. You can also follow us on Instagram. All our Instagram handle are on the screen. Our Twitter handle is also there. You follow up our tweets. You could also subscribe to our YouTube channel, where you'll be getting an update of all our videos. Once again, I say thank you for listening and have a wonderful time. See you soon.